Recently, I was talking with my friend Ben, and he was just expressing how there's so many of his female friends who have gone through bad relationships or have been hurt by men, and he was just saying how much his heart breaks over that and that he wants to reach out to them, but he's like, but you know, I gotta be careful because then they'll fall in love with me. And I was like, oh, how presumptuous of you, Ben. He's like, no, that's not what I meant. You know what I meant. And I did know what he meant because I've heard from so many of you who, you know, are trying to figure out this fine line of how do I not lead somebody on? How do I not lead someone on? And I would say it's kind of, we have to figure out the different elements of what it means to lead someone on. I would say generally the way people have defined this is when it's the kind of situation where a relationship is ambiguous. Maybe you guys are acting like your boyfriend and girlfriend, but there's not been anything clearly defined, and then one day the person just kind of disappears and dissolves and you're like, wait, what? I'm confused. And so if you've ever done that, I would suggest saying you're sorry to the person that you did that to, or just don't ever do it again. Or I will find you. But those are people who definitely had impure motives or were just unwise. And those people, especially the people that have impure motives, they're probably not watching this. And I said to Ben, I said, you know what, you do need to reach out to your female friends, especially if they've been hurt by your gender, as you know, brothers and sisters in Christ, especially as we say, we need to redeem those images that people might have of how they've been treated by a woman or how they've been treated by a man if you are a healthy person. And so you shouldn't have this fear because I don't think you have ill motives. Now, if you're trying to reach out to the female friends in your life to get them into bed, then you are one of those people. And he was like, no, that's not me. And I was like, I know that's not you, and that's why you need to have the freedom. But the reality is, if you are kind to people, if you are who you are and you're a good man, there's a reality that a woman may fall for you, but you don't have to then conclude that you were leading them on. They just liked you and you may not have the same feelings back. And so I want to encourage those people then who are on the receiving end, where they're going, I thought this guy liked me, or I, you know, he, and then he didn't. You have to step back and go, is someone like Ben, is he someone who leads people on? Are you now telling people, hey, this guy led me on? Because if you are, and that's not who that person's character is, then you're ruining their reputation for future dating experiences. So too, if you guys are dating, you say, hey, I like you, you like me, let's date, let's figure this out. And then one of you decides, you know what, I don't think this is the best relationship for me. I thought maybe it would work, but it didn't, and you end the relationship, which is normal. And then the other person, to make sense of their feelings, says, well, that person just led me on. They were just leading me on. Were they? Or were you just dating and then they decided not to keep dating you? Again, be very careful of giving them that label because you are adding to their reputation. So that's my challenge when it comes to how we label each other, and that's also my encouragement to people who are trying to figure out, how do I not lead someone out on? How do I not lead? You just have pure motives and you treat everybody the same, and then you won't be leading them on. And if they do say that, they say, you led me on, then ask people in your life, is the way I treated this person, was it different than other people? Was I intentionally, you know, and let the truth of people who really know you outweigh someone who's just trying to make sense of their hurt and their rejection by labeling you.
On the next Ask Joy, Walter wraps himself in a cocoon of reminiscence. So love the one you hold.